This radio drama you're about to listen to is titled The Contemporary Nativity Story, and it is brought to you by WiG Radio.
Once upon a time, in the town of Reliable, where virginity was a noble thing, there lived a family of three daughters whose father died many years back. These girls lived with their mother, who worked hard along with her daughters to fend for themselves. The oldest daughter, Maria, one of the most pious and kindest maidens in the village, was engaged to be married to the town's most innovative carpenter and most eligible bachelor, Joe. Other maidens in the town burned with envy and jealousy for Maria because Joe only had eyes for her. They were always seeking her downfall. One day, three of the maidens going to fetch some water from the stream were deep in conversation when they sighted Maria returning from the stream with a jar of water balanced on her head.
For the time when I get married to a very rich man and stop doing menial jobs such as this. I will look for better things. I mean, look at me. A whole militia. Winner of the last three ladies beauty parade in our town. My inestimable beauty deserves a more inestimable wealth. You know.
Inestimable wealth?
Mm-hmm.
I thought you always wanted Joe to notice you.
Mm.
He's not very wealthy, you know. If it's wealth you're looking for, then you had better start looking elsewhere.
Bibi, you should know by now that Malicia is confused. She wants to marry a rich man, yet she keeps paying after Joe. Apart from the fact that he's not even from a very wealthy family. He already has Maria as a fiancé and she still wants to die there.
Gossip, what is that supposed to mean now? I don't like it though. What is your business with my things now? Yes, I want to marry a rich man. But does that mean I can't be doing a little flexing with Joe? And what's my business with whether you have a fiancé or not? Anything can happen to Maria tomorrow. And the partaking is allowed. Thank you, sir.
Oh, I hear you, Miss Overtaker. You shall know that even if Maria drops dead tomorrow, Joe will rather live the rest of his days as a bachelor than look at another medium.
It's true. What's that even about? Why does he carry her on a pedestal like she's a goddess?
I don't understand.
And it's not just him who thinks so highly of her. Every day my parents will tell me, Gossie, why can't you be more like Maria? She's very respectful, very hardworking, very kind, very industrious, this and that. Like, why will I respect someone that does not respect me?
My uncle too, he said I should be hardworking and meek like Maria, that I'm too sharp-tongued. I know I can be lazy and insulting, but is it my fault people are always getting on my nerves? Me? I will lash them with words. I don't care.
Exactly, me too. Nobody can ride me in this town. I will not be a dunce for anybody. If you give me two, I will return with 10. Remove one of my teeth. I will remove 5 of yours.
Malicia, Didi, here she comes, the goddess of red matter.
I don't know. She's not even pretty. I don't know why Joe is always flowing over her. What does she have in her doing?
See this, Malicia. This means that Joe just thinks his Maria can do no wrong. I'm just waiting for her to make a little slip so he can see that she's not so perfect after all.
Good afternoon, old sisters.
Good afternoon, Maria.
Do you girls think she heard us?
And so? If she did, she won't do anything. Why is she not meek?
Let's talk about something more interesting. They go seeking the builders and carpenters so long to return from their assignments in the neighboring town. How long does it take to build a simple town hall? I beg, I miss my Joe.
Your Joe. Let Maria hear you and come back. You'll know she's not so meek.
Those were the types of conversations that took place behind Maria's back. Sometimes she heard them. at other times she ignored them. Finally, Maria got back home to meet her mom.
Mama, I'm back. The stream seems full today, but I'm prepared to return. I think I'll just continue tomorrow.
Well done, dear. You've even tried. I've cooked and your food is inside that blue plate. So go and eat and rest, eh?
Ah, thank you, Mama. By the way, where did Eliza and Sally go?
Eliza and Sally. They already went out for the Young Ladies Festival. They said they have some things to do for them. And I think they are part of the planning committee or something.
Are you serious? I didn't even know. Those girls, eh? No wonder they've been so busy lately. I will eat, take a nap, and maybe join them later.
Alright, my dear.
So Maria went to take a nap. And while she was sleeping, she had a strange dream.
Greetings, highly favored ones. The Lord is with you. I am Angel Gabriel, sent by the Lord to bring you glad tidings. The Lord has noticed your virtue, steadfastness, and good, even in the face of adversity and peer pressure in this town, and thus has chosen you for this great honor. You will give birth to a child, and you are to call his name Jesus. You will deliver his people from sin, your eternal enemy.
Mama, I just had a strange dream. An angel came to me with a prophecy that I'm going to have a divine baby who will save our town from Lucifer. Can you imagine?
A baby that will save us from sin.
Can you hear what I'm saying? This amount of our kids and worries have made it conquer for a very long time. And everyone has given up hope. See, you could have given people false hope here. Yeah, this is your strange dream.
Ah, Mama, I don't know. But that was what I saw, and this one seems so real. Mama, I could almost touch the angel.
You are really serious about this, Maria.
Ah, yes, oh Mama. Have I ever lied to you?
But this dream is very strange and carries weight. The angels won't give you any specific time that the baby will arrive.
Ah, no.
Hey, it's okay. It will be after your marriage to Joe anyway. But don't know if it will be your first, second, or even third child. When he returns from his assignment with the other chemicals and builders, you talk to him about the whole matter with the angels.
Ah, Joe. I really miss him more. I wonder what's taking them so long to return. It's been 3 months since they left for the neighboring town. Or is it not just to build a town hall?
See this small girl. What do you know? You think a big treasure like that is small work? To be back soon, so don't bother yourself. I just will marry you when you return. Andrew is a good boy. And I know you can't wait to be his wife too.
Mama, I hear you. I just wish Papa were alive so he could witness my wedding. Anyway, let me wash my face and go join my sisters at the town square.
Okay, now go wear my sisters. And make sure your sisters get back on time before I start looking for you people.
Okay, Mama. See you later. And I'll pick up some bananas on my way back.
I think it's a big wonderful daughter. I'm keeping them branches even in this small town. Who is your father? I'm being their mother. She's down passed away. Please, let the meaning of my husband be revealed to us in time. I need to wait for our life to be revealed.
Three weeks later, Maria is found vomiting with signs of pregnancy written all over her.
Sister, you're really scaring me. Please hold it together. Mama will soon be here. Actually, I've sent Sally to look for her. Oh God. Please help my sister.
Sister, I found Mama at Lawrence's place. She's coming already. Please be strong. Hold on. I ran as fast as I could.
Is she okay? Maria, what do you eat now? Sandy just rushed into my Mama Florence's house to call me that you've been throwing up since. What do you think you? Open your eyes, open. Ah, Maria. I think you are pregnant though.
What? Upper Mama. But you know I'm still a virgin. I've not done any man at all.
Maria, these signs don't lie. I've been pregnant 3 times. You know, I've assisted the midwife, the Lord. Oh, I know the signs quite well. You have pregnancy written all over you. I'm not mistaken. How did I miss this for this long?
But how is it possible that I'm pregnant when I've not even as much as held hands with another man apart from Joe? No, I can't be pregnant to Mama. I just can't be pregnant. What will I tell you when he returns? I will have eyes for him.
Sister, I hope it's not that you were raped though.
Keep quiet, Sally. How does she know if she were raped?
Sorry.
Sister, I believe that you have never been with another man. So, are you sure it's not that angel's prophecy that is coming to pass? After all, you yourself said you did not specify the time the baby will come.
That's true. But that can't be. He didn't say it was this soon.
I thought he meant when I was married to Joe already.
Ah, why me? How do I explain this to people? Who will even believe me? People already look at me funny in this town.
Oh,
can't be.
Hey. But is there any other reasonable explanation, Maria? You said you've never been with another man. And I believe you because since you were young, you have never lied to me. What Elisa said is only the only thing that makes sense right now. And what we'll do is that we'll go to the senior midwife to confirm this pregnancy. Then wait until the building team returns next week. So you can explain everything to Joe.
Will you believe me?
Let's just hope and pray for the best. We'll go to the senior midwife first thing tomorrow morning.
I will rise from beneath the dust. I will shake all the pain and the sorrows from my past.
Joe is back from the outing of the builders to build the temple, and his friend Zach decides to pay him a visit in order to find out if the rumor going on in town about Maria's pregnancy is true.
Joe, mm-hmm. I have something. Mm-hmm. Wait, is it true?
See, Zach, I'm not in the mood. What is it that you heard?
Oh God, I heard that Maria is pregnant. Is that true? The ladies have been talking about it all over. So I made up my mind to come and see. How come? The pregnancy is about 4 weeks now. You were gone on your building assignment almost 2 months now.
My brother, I've heard too. I mean, just imagine. Why do you think I'm in such a mood? I don't understand this thing, Tina. I don't understand.
Wow. So I hope they are just rumors. They are like not the truth.
Rumors. It was the first news I got when I returned from the journey yesterday. As the merchants and other townsfolk were greeting us, I wondered why Maria and her sisters weren't even among them. Wiki just blotted it out that Maria is pregnant, and some of the other merchants started laughing. But I had to immediately just go and see Maria straight.
Wait, and what did she say? What exactly did she do?
She was just babbling about dreams, about visions, about prophecies, one angel, divine baby, and sin. Like I'm stupid. She wasn't making any sense at all. Her mother and sisters are convinced of her story too. They were just begging me to try to understand. How can an angel impregnate someone?
I can't imagine.
So, I wish you would just open up to me and tell me the truth. I mean, I'm tired.
The truth is that she has probably been with someone else. She cheated on you. Simple. It pains me to say this, but as Maria is my friend, and also I have always known her to be virtuous. But what about what other explanation is here, Joe? I knew she was too good to be true.
Hmm.
But wait, how did the town folks find out?
Well, Sally just told me that the junior midwife's assistant was there when Maria and her mother went to confirm the pregnancy from the senior midwife.
Oh, really?
So I think she has a personal vendetta against Maria for whatever reason. So she leaked the news of Maria's pregnancy to the whole town.
Wow. Well, practically every maiden has a grudge against Maria.
Yeah.
Is it what it is? Let me advise you. Let me just advise you. As a friend, you can't bear the responsibility of a pregnancy that does not belong to you.
Yeah.
As the most eligible bachelor in this town, you already have girls queuing at your door. Leave Maria and find another maiden.
Mm.
Hadn't Malicia been trying to get your attention, why not go for her?
Malicia is too vain.
Then,
but I still love Maria very much, very much. She has never lied to me, but I just can't bring myself to understand or even believe this story.
So not
this
story.
Wow. I know, it's just too absurd, but you're right though. I can't take responsibility for someone else's baby.
No, you're talking.
What am I think what I'll just do is I'll just break up with her quietly, as discreet as possibly as possible, and advise her mom and her sisters to take her out of town so she won't be disgraced.
No,
she's already a laughing stock and I'm not really liking that, but
see, that's the problem I have. You are just too nice.
You
and Maria deserve each other. I just hope you are able to work something out, because I won't like to see her disgraced either.
Yeah.
But I'm not happy about it. Anyway, whatever decisions you take, I've got your back, dude.
Thank you, Zach. Thank you.
Yeah.
So Joe decided to privately divorce Maria. But that night, he had a dream, and in that dream, he had an encounter with an angel.
Joe, this is Angel Gabriel, and I was sent by the Lord. The Lord commend your uprightness and steadfastness in this immoral town. You must not be afraid to take Maria as your wife, like you once planned to. For that pregnancy she carries is of the Holy Spirit, not of anyone. Maria has always remained faithful to you. You will be an earthly father to that child and call his name Jesus, for he will save your people from sin, your eternal enemy.
Wow, that was only a dream. Wow. Thank you, Lord, for revealing this to me. I've been so unfair to Maria, and I need to make things right with her. Oh, she never lied to me after all. First thing, when it's bright, I'll just go to her place, and I'll set everything right.
Wait, I don't think I can continue. We have to stop somewhere quickly. I think the baby is already coming.
Really? And I suspected as much. I knew we shouldn't have come on this journey. I'm so sorry, my dear. I'm so sorry for putting you through this stress. Hold on, my dear. I think I can see a farm up ahead. We'll soon get there. Please, eh?
Your baby is so beautiful. The girls and I have cleaned him up. Do you want to hold him now, or you rest first, Mrs. Maria?
Oh, let me hold him now. I'm so excited. I can rest later.
You did very well, my dear. Thank God for seeing you through this delivery. Look at that beautiful baby. You're welcome to the world, Jesus. Tell me, hold it, Maria.
You're welcome to the world, Jesus. We love you.
Thank you so much, Mrs. We do not know how we can repay you enough for your kindness. My wife and I are greatly indebted to you.
It's no problem. In fact, I have been having dreams and revelations concerning this particular situation. When she knocked on our door that your wife was in labor, I immediately felt this inexplicable joy in my spirit. I know this baby is special and his birth was meant to happen this way. So you owe us nothing. It's our pleasure.
Auntie, so people are outside. They said they are from the eastern town and have come to see and worship their baby.
Do you know who they are? Should I let them in?
Throughout Maria's pregnancy, divine things were happening. I mean, one thing after the other, things none of us could really explain. If this man say they came to worship him, I mean, they must have been led. So let them in, please. Let them.
We greet you, blessed couple. God showed us the great sign of the divine baby coming today. Who will deliver us from the great enemy, sin?
Thank you very much, my fathers. This is truly an honor, and we give all glory to God for this wonderful miracle. The child has been so peaceful since he came into the world. Do you want to hold him?
Wow, this is really good news. We are really fortunate for God to have remembered us and sent us a helper again.
Very true. I cannot wait for our return to Retnaza so we can show Mama, my sisters and your family our baby. I know Eliza and Sally could not wait to be aunties. By the way, how do you think he's going to save us from Lucifer?
I don't know yet, but I'm sure God who gave him to us and deemed us worthy to be his custodian will reveal everything as time goes on. For now, let's just take care of him as best as we can and wait for the day.
And that was how the Savior of the world was born. His name is Jesus, and he is said to save you and deliver you from sin. In case you want to ask Jesus Christ to come into your life today, you can say this word of prayer with faith. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I realize that I'm a sinner. Come into my life. Be my Lord and my Savior. I believe you came into this world to die for my sin, and you rose up on the third day for my justification. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Amen. Would love to hear from you on how we can help you move your relationship with God to the next level.
Cast Olawale Perfect as narrator and Angel Gabriel. Cephas Ibrahim as Joe. Jerry Uwada as Zach, Joe's friend. Juliet Osuku as Maria. Omoumi Abolade as Maria's mother. Ajiri Amata as wise man. Antoniette Ayalume as farm aunt. Muyosore Makoni as Malicia. Shehu Ajayi as Gossip. Executive Director Olawale Perfect. Scripts by Shehu Ajayi and Jerry Uwada. Produced by Omoumi Abolade. Sound effects Cephas Ibrahim and Jerry Uwada. Location WiGRadio Studio. And I am Roland Ibi. Thank you very much for listening. God bless you.
This radio drama you're about to listen to is titled The Contemporary Nativity Story, and it is brought to you by WiGRadio.